Thank you. group of people that come to the race. And so there's something that you may come up with somebody and you can use every day for them and make them work, but their life, it holds them up. That helps them to look at the people. So I talked a little bit about what accessibility means and why it's important. But what can we do as developers to ensure that people with a range of disabilities are able to use accessible tools? So one of the things you can do is to decide to add your access to the facility. So like I mentioned before, the first time you turn on talk back in the phone, I think you turn to portal. And you really did it. I've never ever even hit it at some point about 2 years ago. I went to a talk where somebody showed me what it was like to use talk back on a community basis. So it's really worth taking a few minutes to learn how to use it and just run through the feature and over to the app before you're about to release and see how that works. A lot of examples of CD, you know, when you're getting physical guidelines and things like that, it's pretty straightforward to read, right? There are text here, so you can read it. There's an image, so you can see the description. There's like a section for the winter, like yelling at you pretty much constantly if you have an image here or an image button in the body description. Most of the time, it's right. But sometimes it's not clear how much information just actually be read out loud. So, for example, maybe you have a list of several actionable items that the user can choose from. And each of those items has both an icon and a title. It doesn't make much sense to read the icon and the title. That's important. It wastes the user's time. There's no reason for that item to be focusable on it. You can just type the entire row, for example. So, there's things like that where it really makes a difference if you go through and test out all of your strings, see what's read out loud, because a lot of the time you will want that content to change. And another example is maybe you have a list of messages and have your user picture next to each message. You don't need to read user pick the message every time because the person wants to see the picture, the reading or just the picture that they want to talk about it doesn't go back to the memory, it shouldn't be read. Some people still recognize that I don't have a link here, it's like something you struggle with. And if anybody has ideas on how to maybe optimize for this, I'd love to hear it. Another thing I want to talk about is other types of navigation, using the keyboard, using the keypad, using the switch. People's developer guidance to enable focus based navigation. Make sure users can navigate this thing without using primary-based or software directional controls. So, like you said, do you have some trackball? Maybe the keyboard is keyboard. Maybe they have a photo of your trackball in 2015 or the whole community. Maybe they're using navigation justice because that's just the way that's easiest for them to navigate. In a few cases, you might need to make the user engagement keyboard as flexible as you want it to be, or customize the direction that you will be navigating throughout these items. the idea of navigating through a new screen was actually people do. And this is kind of the most important. You can see that it focused on the back of the portal when it started, so I can't navigate that way. I can't really do anything. And so what I had to do was go in I really want to go. There's no